Okay, so for primer, I'm just taking my Hangover RX primer just because I am in love with this primer and I can't stop using it. And drugstore ones just don't work out for me and they break me out like crazy. So I feel like the higher end stuff works a lot better for my skin just because I have acne prone skin. So, and then just to prime my eyelids, as usual, I'm taking my Tarte Shape Tape and just using that all over my lid. Okay, so for the crease shade, I am just using this yellow shade. At first I used one from the Jaclyn Hill palette, but I felt like it was too dark, so I went in with a brighter shade, and this is from the Be Bella palette. It's the B36 or 35. I will list everything down below. I can't think of it on the top of my head, so I'm just making it a little bit brighter because we are going to be using orange and I want to have that gradient effect. So I'm just going to be applying it to the other eye, and I know my right eye, which is your left, will be a little bit darker, but that's okay because we're going to go in with orange, so it won't really matter. And then I'm just taking this orange shade from the Sassy Siennas palette from Dose of Colors. Like I said, I will put everything in a description box, or I will put it somewhere on the screen naming each shadow that I use. So I'm just putting this basically on top of where we put the yellow, but not going all the way to the very top, just because we want to have that gradient and effect from the orange to the yellow. Okay, so for right here, I'm taking a clean, fluffy blending brush and just making sure everything is nice and blended out. And then I'm going in with a smaller, more tapered blending brush and taking a deeper orange shade just to create some depth for the look. And I'm just focusing it on the outer corner and in the lower crease, more going towards the lid. And it's okay if you get eyeshadow on your lid, it's totally fine because we're just going to be creating a cut crease, so it won't really matter. And then I'm taking a fluffier brush and just kind of smoking out that darker orange shade, just so it can look a little bit more intense and not so flat. Okay, so I already cut my crease and I just use concealer just because it's easier for me and it looks cleaner. So I'm just taking this blue shade, I believe it's called Pool Party from the Jaclyn Hill palette, and just applying this to my lid. And I used glitter glue after I did the concealer, and then I sprayed my brush. So I dipped my flat brush into the shadow and then I sprayed it just to give it a more intense look, because I really want the blue to pop with the orange just so we can have that fiery, you know, look going on. And then I'm just gonna meet it to where it touches the orange, and then I'm going back in with the orange and kind of blending it together with the blue just so we can have that gradient effect between the blue and the orange. And then I'm gonna take a fluffier brush and kind of blend everything out. And so now I am taking a flat brush and I'm applying the LA Girl Pro HD Matte Foundation, I believe that's what it's called. And I am just applying this to my face just because I feel like applying foundation with a brush instead of my finger is a lot more hygienic. And, you know, even though I clean my fingers and stuff and wash them, I still want a clean brush to apply the foundation. And then I'm just taking my Real Techniques sponge and just blending everything out. I've actually been really liking this foundation. It's become one of my favorites, even though I have oily skin, but I don't really like matte foundations because they can be a little bit too drying and flat on my skin. So I rather prefer to go with a glowy foundation, but this one's a really good alternative too, and just to kind of switch things up a little bit. Staring at two different views on your window ledge. Coffee is gone cold, it's like time froze. There you go with you floating down, I wish you were. It's like I'm always causing problems for them. I didn't need to put you through this, I could. We got a sweetness under the carpet. I hope that I can turn back the time to make it all alright. All alright for us. I promise to build a new world for us two. With you in the middle. Yo. So for highlight, I actually use a Wet n Wild highlighter. I believe this is called the Golden Flower Crown, I believe. Like I said, I will list everything down in the description box, but I really am liking this highlighter, and sorry about my voice. I'm starting to lose it, so sorry if it's like all weird and crackly. But I've been loving this highlighter. It's cheap. It's like $4. You can get it at Walmart, CVS, any local drugstore. So I highly recommend you get it because it is just stunning. Like, look at that highlight, girl. And yeah, so this completes the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.